This is Terry, and I'll be showing you how to do a shark jaw Mad Max style bracelet. First, get two strands at about 5 feet each. Fuse the ends together. Show you how to do that real quick. Just mud the ends. Just press them together. Just roll them. And this will be hot, so be careful. Go. Find the length that you need for your wrist. Lay it out. First thing you do is just do a regular Cooper stitch. Take your left strand, bring it across the core. Take your right strand, which is the black one that I have here. Bring it over the left strand, behind everything, and through the loop. And then just tighten it down. What to do next, this is the reason why I have two different colors here. Take the strand that's going down, put it through the middle, off to the left, and then you take your one that's going up, bring it down through the middle, then back up through the loop, then just tighten it down. So that's the first one. Same thing with everything else. Just bring this around through the middle. Take the black, take it down through the middle, not through the loop. All right. Let me do a couple more of these for you so you can see what's going on exactly. Take the gray strand, put it down through the middle, off to the left. Then take the black strand, down through the middle, out through the loop. So let's keep on going with this. Take the gray strand, put it down through the middle. Take the black strand, down through the middle, through the loop. So every time you should have it looking like this. Get my hand out of the way here, this is a black cord. Let's tighten it down. And the first one's going to look a little wonky because of the Cooper stitch. But after you get this going, this should be fine. All right, let's do a couple more. Gray cord. Down through the middle, off to the left. Keep this after the loop. Black down through the middle. And through the loop. So we'll continue on this, gray, around, through the middle, off to the left, so right now, right, left, left, right, okay. Take the black, down through the middle, then through the loop. Across the black strand, down through the middle, under the gray strand, to the black strand, down through the middle between the two core, then out through the loop. Tighten it all up. That's basically it right there. So I'm going to finish this, and then I'll show you how to probably finish this guy when I get down to the bottom. Alright, when you get down to here, what you do is get your FIDS, and you just stick them right through that bottom loop. So it looks kind of like the actual stitching. Like that. What you do is, there's going to be two little loops here. One here, and one here. Put the black loop, the black cord through the black loop. Alright, there we go. Unfortunately, it's now a loose draw. Thought it was going to be a tight one, but now it's going to be a loose one. Alright, so these will come up like that. Now what I will do here is I'm going to show you all how to do a diamond knot real quick. I always set it up like this. It's just a little bit easier. Right. Make a loop. Actually, I don't think I'll have enough room here for a diamond knot. No, I'll have just enough. Alright. You do a loop. Just lay it across it like that. Bring this guy under that black strand. Through the middle. Then back out through that loop. Alright, I'm going to tighten this down just a little bit so I got some more play here. Alright. Now, go ahead and get my finger out of here. What you do is, you take these strands, bring them around the opposite color strand here, bring them up through the middle. Bring it down, through the middle. Now, once you get used to this, all you really have to do to tighten it up is just pull straight out. All you gotta do now is just fix the strands on it. I'll do that real quick. There's that one. There's that one. And then up through. Tighten down, tighten down, tighten down. And that's basically the diamond knot. All you do then is just snip and singe the ends coming out of the knot. This down real good. My little tool here. Do that with it. And there it is. Hope you all like this tutorial. I'll have more in the future. Y'all have a good one.